Alex Sharman suffers from a rare fear called nephophobia. From birth, he has been terrified of those white, fluffy water particles in the sky we call clouds.
It started like when I was a baby. I used to see them in the sky and I'd just cover my eyes, you know, trying not to look up. And it would stop me from actually going outside. I remember all the kids on the block used to say, "Oh, come on Alex, come play," but I just couldn't go outside. I just couldn't face it.
This documentary charts the life story of Alex's phobia as we try to uncover the origin. With the help of researchers and cloud experts, Alex will find out if it's not too late to overcome his terrible fear, or whether he'll have to succumb to a life of solitude in his own home.
I sometimes stay in for months, days, just waiting for there to be a clear sky so I can go outside and enjoy the fresh air, but I just can't go out there when they're up there, you know? I stay inside checking the weather just to make sure they're not there.
Alex lives on his own in Wanstead, London. He was born the youngest of three brothers and five sisters, all of which followed in the footsteps of their parents and work in the city in highly successful careers.
I mean, all my siblings, they're quite successful. They've gone on to big jobs like banking, was it Joe's and Properties Development Now. And, you know, they all went to private schools, well-educated, but just because of my fear, I never had the opportunity. I had to stay indoors and get home-tutored by my parents.
Due to Alex's fear of clouds, his lifestyle has been significantly restricted. He spends about 90% of his time indoors, under his roof, protected from clouds. His condition means he has to have a roof over his head at all times, be it a car or a house. But sometimes getting from his house to his car can prove to be quite a challenge in itself.
It was a teenage wedding and the old folks wished him well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. They furnished off an apartment with a two-room Robux sale. Coming worked out well. C'est la vie, say the old folks. It goes to show you never can tell.
Yeah. Alex is on his way to see a psychiatrist who specializes in phobias.
Yeah, hopefully this guy can get to the root of the problem. Maybe even overcome it, you know.
Other than the camera crew and two of Alex's neighbours, the psychiatrist will be the first contact he's had with another human for 4 months.
Ah, Alex, good to see you.
Come in.
Dr. Jeremy Farsbottom of Cambridge University specialises in patients who suffer from life-altering phobias such as Alex's and helps them to overcome them.
Now, Alex, firstly, what I do is I actualise myself into your personality, into your life role, to find out where and when this phobia first occurred. And then I will try and understand why you have such a phobia by getting inside your head.
Literally?
Not literally, but it's just a way to help me to understand how this phobia of yours occurred.
No.
Right, now. When was the first time you saw a cloud as a threat or danger to yourself? Try and remember.
Since forever. They've always been watching me.
Right, so do you remember when this first occurred? Perhaps when you were a baby?
When I was a baby. They used to watch me sleep.
Good. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to try and find if there is an unconscious role in this phobia of yours. And I'm going to show you a series of images. And I want you to respond to them as soon as you see them. Mm. So the first thing that pops into your head when I show you the image, okay? Mm. First image.
Dog.
Interesting. Second image.
Eraser. Okay.
The third image.
Chimpanzee.
Okay then. And the final image. Alex, wait!
Who's on set?
Alex. It's just a picture of us. Alex, come on.
After much persuasion, the camera crew and Dr. Fastbottom convince Alex to continue with the therapy, despite his reluctance.
Right, now Alex, I'm going to draw an image for you right now, and I want you to just say the first thing that pops into your mind when I show you this drawing that I've done. Don't be shy about anything, just say the first thing that comes into your mind. Okay.
As Alex reflected on his therapy, he got more and more annoyed and agitated, as he knew he'd let himself down. The next morning, the camera crew awake to see Alex getting ready. He's preparing to go outside. His endless scanning of the weather forecast, and of course looking out of his window, has finally paid off. There is report of blue skies.
Today, Alex?
It's been a really nice day. I mean, the sky's clear. There's no clouds in the sky.
One of the last trips Alex will make on his quest to cure his phobia is to cloud expert Dr. Hershan Joseph Schniebler of Yeshiva University.
Clear my paperwork.
Dr. Schniebler specializes and is a professor in the very thing Alex despises. Clouds.
Alex.
Thanks.
Alex, what you have to remember is clouds come in many different shapes and forms. They come in short, long, big, and small. But what you must remember is underneath they are all the same.
Ah, I get it. So what you're saying...
Quiet! I have to talk. So what I'm trying to say, Alex, is if you took a ring, for example, and then cut it open, and then compare it to another cloud, they're made of the exact same thing. Water particles.
Water particles?
That's right, Alex. Clouds are no more than water particles. What I'm saying, Alex, is clouds are indeed harmless. They're just simply condensation.
So those fluffy white things we're talking about in the sky, right? I mean, that, look, do I have to be afraid of them or not?
Yes. For a matter of fact, many people believe that clouds hold the answers to other life forms. They say they are watching us humans constantly, waiting for the day to strike down upon us, and whoever lies beneath these clouds, we are forced to spend an eternity slaved by the evil subhuman creatures, and forced to live a brutal and torturous life for the rest of their existence.
And so Alex left the cloud expert the same way he came in. Although pondering on a brief moment of salvation, he knew in his heart he would never fully recover from his fear. He knew he was destined to live the rest of his life in solitude, away from people, away from the world, and more importantly, away from clouds.
I don't think I'm strange. I mean, everyone has a fear. There's loads of different phobias that people have, you know, whether it's dark, spiders. I've read people even have, like, fears of heights, but, you know, it's just a shame because of my fear, I have to alter my whole life because of it. Just hopefully someday, I'll be able to walk down the road and not be scared of them. You know, someday, maybe I'll overcome this.